time for some stuff you actually missed last week. Yeah.
Today on the end of the show, Smosh goes to...
Whoa. I immediately have less bad feelings.
Wait a minute. This is nostalgia nirvana in here. Already feeling the sweet embrace of yesteryear.
Yeah! Oh, I'm so glad to have you all here! Oh, I don't know why I was so hesitant about it before. Hold on, I'm gonna show you around the old patent palace.
Is that my glowworm? Look at how creepy it looks. Oh my goodness, look at all the memories you've got stored in this place, Patton.
There seems to be a high concentration of items encompassing your education here, Thomas.
Oh, man.
So many years of chemical engineering and science that you decided to flush down the metaphorical toilet.
I forgot about everything I learned.
Oh, good times.
And hopefully more good times ahead. There's always time for you to abandon your current lifestyle and pursue a doctorate.
Sweet Barbara Streisand, the show memories, the performances, the attempts at dancing we think went okay, but would prefer not to focus on.
I can box step at the best of them, though. 5, 6, 7, 8.
No need to demonstrate.
Oh, for crying out loud, are these all your old journal entries and stories that you wrote in middle school? If these are so cringy, why would they be here?
Because they're still Thomas's work, and it's very fun to look back on. No, don't be embarrassed, Virgil.
You really liked drawing yin-yangs on the margins of your notes.
That and houses. A little box, the roof, and two windows, and a door.
All right, so we're here. Now we can let the reminiscing take place and get it out of the way. Who wants to start?
Yeah, I think we've already started, Logan.
Oh, great. I don't know how this works.
Hey, remember this?
Is that...
The rainforest rap?
Oh, my stars, it is.
Spitting bars, it is.
Yoga from Star Trek? All right, turn it off. You don't want to copyright strike.
All right, this is what inspired your interest in helping to preserve the rainforest,
and then helping the environment, which in turn led to you pursuing chemical engineering in the first place.
It seriously all stemmed from that simple little tune.
What?
Tropical rainforest? More like bopical rainforest. The song is a bop!
It stuck with you so much, I can still recall it to this day. Welcome to the jungle.
It's so exciting, exalting,
mysterious, and we are inviting you on an adventure.
Stop. Please. Too much. Embarrassing.
Oh, man, this takes me back.
Hey, you remember this?
My little hardcover book is, oh my goodness. Wait, I talked about my imagination, all the things I could do with it, the things I could create. Oh my goodness, the memories. This is me electrifying my brother.
Oh, the accolades you racked up on the stage, the cheers, the laughs.
Look, the first community theater award you ever received, a Golden Apple. Oh, you remember?
Yeah. Oh my goodness, yes. I won Best Actor for playing Coco in Hot Mikado.
One of the first times you were awarded for acting weird.
And more would follow.
And therefore more faux golden fruit may await you if you continue to pursue your nonsense art of leaping around in front of everybody, shouting about things you've never experienced.
Thomas, I bet this might bring you back.
Okay. This is all very nice, but you guys gotta stop handing me things all at once, okay?
I'm sorry.
That is the smell of Christmas.
In a box!
Yeah! The tree, the cookies, the eggnog that your parents made you?
Oh, the unhealthy. Oh, those memories were so thrilling and so mysterious.
See, there is an annual event you have to look forward to.
Yeah, but I mean, like, it's different now. I mean, as an adult, it's... I don't know, it's not the same as when you're a kid.
Well, that may be the case. However,
old poems you wrote? Oh, you were trying so hard to be edgy. I feel like I'm an archaeologist that dug up an ancient cringe compilation.
Look, I had a lot on my mind growing up, especially as a teenager.
That you did. Constantly escaping into your mind to get away from real life, wondering when you were going to start liking girls, creating these other worlds where things just made more sense.
Ah, yes, those were hectic and busy times for me.
Well, that's about the time that you upgraded from small nuisance to giant thorn in our side.
And for good reason.
Yeah, it was a busy time for me, too. I mean, the stakes were high. Thomas was really starting to develop as a person then.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Oh, that's funny. So I might not have had Roman create half as many of the stories and worlds as he did without Virgil giving me reason to. That's weird.
Well, fortunately, things make more sense now. Or rather, will make more sense in the future, right?
I guess.
I mean, that's the goal, right?
Developing a clearer perspective?
Somewhat, yes. Is that not what's happening?
I'm not sure what's happening.
I'll show you what's hippity happening.
Is that one of my pound puppies?
Ah, chocolate!
His name is Chocolate.
Oh!
Boy, times were amazing back then. Some might say way better.
Wait. He's just so sweet and good and pure and happy and wholesome and sweet and lovely. And I'm running out of things to say, man, I miss all this.
Oh man, remember when our outfits used to look like this? Wow, so embarrassing.
Ah, feels like only yesterday.
We changed in the last video.
Man, your room is awesome. Like, I don't know why you would want to leave it, ever. Like, heck, I don't want to leave my room half the time.
What? Well, I...
Thomas, looking back at these euphoric memories sure does inspire hope for the future, does it not?
Yeah, sure.
Look at this! I used to think this was the coolest thing. It has buttons.
What?
Get out.
I know!
Well, I know you're gonna flip out at this. Crossed. Buns.
Yep, this place does have it all.
Ugh, it sure does.
Why is that even in there?
But think of everything the future has in store.
Virgil, are you okay?
Oh my goodness, I remember this too!
Oh, the songs you used to put onto mix CDs and play in the car. I mean, Disney Mania much?
I must have listened to Pink's first album like 100 times.
Ah, of course.
Thomas?
Uh-huh.
It might not have been the best idea for you to come here.
Ah, such a foolish oversight on my part. You are a habitual warrior.
Yes, I think that we established that quite a long time ago, Specs.
Oh, is that bad for my room?
Well, I didn't think Thomas was too different from others, but anxiety almost always has a seat at the table whenever he makes any decisions. So I would say he worries more than what would be considered the norm.
Okay, but that still doesn't explain.
I know I told you that nostalgia can cause people to be more optimistic about their future, but for habitual warriors, nostalgia can have an adverse effect on their overall mood. It can sometimes cause them to look back on the past compared to the present period in their lives and cause them to ruminate even more on how their present situation pales in comparison. However incorrect that outlook may be, their anxiety worsens.
Virgil, that's not happening, right?
No.
I'm gonna take that as a yes. Come on, let's go. It's time to end this experiment.
Wait a minute, he can't go now. We haven't even started reminiscing about all the Broadway shows that he's seen.
And all these old photos.
Look at this.
You're right, Logan, we can't leave now. There's still too much to look through.
I don't understand this. What is the worth of memories if they don't spur you on to make new ones? I am familiar with this whole ordeal's origin, but it is in the past now. Thomas, it makes no sense.
Logan, it's fine, it's fine.
But if you would only heed...
Oh, hush, sub-astute teacher.
All of this because Patton can't let go of one person.
Logan, can you stop?
Please? You know what? Fine. If you want to listen to me, this is your issue to resolve. I am outie 50,000.
5,000?
Thank you.
Hey, do you guys remember the fifth season of Lost?